Oh, Miller caught out badly by Rush. And it might set Dalglish on his way, but they get a corner, and it was a sloppy piece of play there by the Spurs number three, Paul Miller, oblivious of the fact that Rush was in behind him. Dalglish with a corner. Ronnie Whelan's up in the box, making a run towards the near post. In fact, got the header in. Wasn't far away either, and Spurs simply failed to pick him up and could have paid the highest price. Crooks. And now it's Mark Lawrence for Liverpool. Oh, hits it straight at Ardiles, but followed through quickly before Ardiles had a chance to bring it under control. A slip by Perryman, but he readjusted quickly enough, and Hoddle tries to get Archibald through behind the Liverpool defence. Archibald all the way! Spurs in the lead, 11 minutes gone. A clumsy sort of goal, but Archibald's persistence paid off. The bounce really went his way. Played there. Lawrence, it bounced back off Archibald. Suddenly he was through and just a little nick with the outside of his right boot as Robelon came out.
Miller.
Long, long ball towards Garth Crooks. Both he and Hazard had gone for it. It was won quite easily by Thompson, who got in a good defensive header there. And it sets Liverpool on their way again. Dalglish twisting and turning, finding Souness, who looks to be in quite commanding form in the midfield for Liverpool this afternoon. Neil finding McDermott. Neil again, time to cross it in. That's Dalglish. Oh, a lovely piece of play by Dalglish! And saved on the line by Clements when Sammy Lee went in. And Liverpool, a knock on the leg for a former teammate, but Liverpool came so close to getting the equaliser there. Kennedy into time, added on for stoppages at the end of the first half. Kennedy going on his way, finding Lee on the far side. Free kick given against Steve Perryman, and the challenge there on Sammy Lee. And there'll just about be time to take it, I would think. And Lee has taken it from the wrong place. It's now with Whelan. A little chip in there towards Dalglish. And in the end, it's Lawrence who hits it way over the top. Hazard again, Archibald again, Hazard again! Good play by Tottenham, and it brought Grobbelaar to his knees. Thompson versus Archibald. Here's Kennedy. Miller backpedalling, could only head the ball to Dalglish, who turns it on to McDermott under the volley, maybe, and pushed away well by Ray Clements. Just a fleeting mistake there in the Tottenham defence. And in the end, Clements saved well. And caught one. Well, it was a lovely little ball there, played by McDermott, by Dalglish rather, and McDermott hitting it on the half volley. There was the save. He's desperate for him now. Look at the anxious faces and the squirming backsides on that bench. Here's Hoddle. Now Hoddle, great save, and a chance for Archibald, knocked away by Souness. Great shot by Hoddle. Knocked away by Grobbelaar, in goes Archibald, and Souness, to the agony of Spurs, gets it away. Souness snapping his wrist and telling the referee to add time on for a bit of time wasting. Galvin getting a cross in, Thompson away, Dalglish right back, in spite of the attentions of Ardiles, still finds his man, and here's Rush. Played inside again for Whelan, the two youngsters in this Liverpool side. Finding Johnson on the far side, the substitute, who's hardly had a touch since he came on. Dalglish couldn't get to it, but he might get to this. Villa going in there, using his shoulder. Johnson playing it in. Whelan!
Continuing to get back quickly at the slightest hint of danger. When Crooks was going forward, then 2, 4, 6, seven men plus the goalkeeper were back behind the ball. It says a lot for them at this stage of a long and strenuous season that their stamina has held up as well as this. But when the chance to go forward is there, they pound forward in numbers, and when the danger is there at the other end, they're back to guard their goal in those same numbers. But at the moment they've got everybody back except Rush, as Ardiles finds Perriman with this free kick. Archibald, Ardiles, and now Crooks, pushed away beautifully by Drogba. First real strike on goal I think we've seen from Garth Crooks today, and he hit it well and Drogba reacted superbly. Here's Kennedy. Now Thompson, very often is at this stage of the game, because the players have become so weary that mistakes tend to creep into the game a little more. Now here's Dalglish on the turn, and Clements just grabbing it before Rush could get in, and his little throw sending Perriman free. It's with Hubble. Good pass by Hubble, finding Perriman again, but Liverpool's throw. Whelan ducking there to get it to Kennedy, trying in turn to put Dalglish in behind them. Well, that was Ardiles' mistake, and it's Rush. And now it's Dalglish. He's onside. Is this the decisive moment? He's played for Whelan, and he's done it again. That's astonishing. The first time he's ever played at Wembley, and he's got two of the goals. Ronnie Whelan. Spurs, after holding a lead until 3 minutes from the end of normal time, are now in desperate danger of losing the League Cup final. So Ardiles' mistake is pounced on. Dalglish now just onside, looks up, plays it back for Whelan, who was begging for it at that point, into the roof of the net. It's got to be something pretty dramatic now, and who knows? Perhaps Spurs can yet pull out something pretty dramatic as Villa. No, it falls for Sammy Lee. And what about that for a ball? Inviting Ian Rush to make a charge, to take it round Price, to play it for David Johnson. Stopped by Clements, but it's not away yet. Rush! 3-1! Ian Rush, the man who scored goals all season, 22 of them, puts the seal on it for Liverpool in extra time, and now there's no coming back for Tottenham. He played the ball unselfishly there towards Johnson, and was there waiting for the return, which eventually came, past Ray Clements, those familiar steps to get today not one trophy but two, the Football League Cup and the new Football League Milk Cup. To be received by the Liverpool captain and the former Spurs junior, Graham Souness. Getting it from Sir Matt Busby. That's the old Football League Cup.